think we are good previous season, you know, some of them are sick, I think. But I guess everybody, it's just, yeah, I want to go through everything I've done. But first of all, thank you for coming. Yeah, I'm very happy to be here with you. One of the reasons I came to England was to share my knowledge of futsal with people in England, because it's not that strong here, but and I was looking forward to do some of this stuff, and hopefully we'll do something else. At least this year that I'll be here in Sheffield. Okay? I'm Ernest, I come from Barcelona right now, coaching Sheffield's first team in National League. As yeah, I was coaching Birmingham, that finished runner up in England. I've been playing for almost 20 years futsal in Spain. I arrived to play 7 million in Spain, so I'm not a great player, but I'm not that bad. Okay? And I came here to coach and to learn a bit more English. Yeah? If you don't understand something about my English, because usually I say something in relation to Spanish, or I say in Spanish words that mean for futsal, and maybe you say that, no, wait, just stop me. Okay, we are here to learn, so you can stop me. I'm not here, I'm not your boss or your teacher, I'm just one more of you. Okay? I'll let you start because I know all of you, because you fill the application form. But if you can say your name and maybe something about where you come from, or your experience in futsal, just to. You know, so, okay, I think one of the good things here in England that we should do is to create an association of coaches, of futsal coaches, that this can help us to develop all of us, so we can share ideas, we can do workshops together. So one of the things to do this kind of workshop is to know each other, to maybe to start a kind of relationship and do some games or some friendlies. Okay, so should we start from here?
Yes, I'm on deck and I'm going to talk to you about the research. We are studying the research, which is going to be
a more
clinical and technology. John, I'm on the Jimmy Pops, and I'm going to talk to you about the research. I'm going to talk to you about the research. I'm going to talk to you about the research.
Just to come to Unifactors, we stick to the two after John Adler in the elements of the culture, we put some of our coaches and we put some of our kids there.
For 6 years, use futsal balls, techniques and things like that. We've grassroots football teams. I've set up a club on the other side of Manchester now, so we can do that, focus on futsal. My name's Oliver, I've just from Junior Blues. We use futsal as an additional training activity, especially for our younger kids. And I'm also chairman of the Chesterfield Futsal League, which hasn't started operations yet, starting in February at the new Queen's Park building. At the moment. So if anybody wants to enter teams that's under 7s, 8s, 9s, 10s in particular, in a league starting in February, let me know. I can my card and you can get in touch.
I'm Adrian, I'm with Porter FC in South West Sheffield. I've had about 15 years experience of the kids team with various teams in various ages. I'm with the Relent at the moment and I'm looking forward to our second dose of futsal starting in February.
Start for the juniors, start for us, all the way up to 10 years.
level children futsal coach. Been playing coach the past 2 or 3 years. Been in grades 9 to 10 of the year.
If he crosses to the other side, then it's a normal play. On the other side. That's why most of the teams play with three keeper at the end, with one player more to try to score. Yeah? And the last difference is the minute sub. Yeah? So, like in basketball, you can swap as many times as you want to play. Yes? Is there any question or rules that you want to go through now? If not, in the ring we can have a chat about it. Not really?
When it goes behind, go for the throw it out.
Yeah.
And you drop it on the floor and then put it in.
No, he never put it on the floor. Yeah, if he saves it, he can do it, but it's not mandatory to do it. He can kick it, yeah. So imagine that the other team has the keeper forward and he saves it, then he can kick and score. It is fine. Yeah, but the ball goes outside, he has to do it. Yeah, and he cannot score it. Yes, any other question? No? Okay, let's go through the stuff, yes? First of all, A, when we coach kids, yeah, we or educate kids, the biggest question, yeah? Okay. For me, is compete. Yeah? We need to teach them to compete. So, not to win, but yes, to understand what to do in each situation, to have 100% effort, to never give up, to avoid silly mistakes. So, if I'm here, I cannot lose a ball here, that means compete, and you are indicating them, yeah? Okay? And to look forward to win, yeah? They need to try to win. Even if they are bad, they should try it to do it, yeah? We have 100% effort to do all the things, yeah? So with these things, we are mixing both, yeah? But we cannot focus just on winning, yeah? And we can focus on just on educating, yeah? But I think, from my point of view, if we promote a competition with them, we'll get better things with education, yeah? Of course, not always, but if you try to educate them and you try to compete, that means that you will have this effort, never give up. Yeah, they'll be concentrated, focused in learning things to do it much better. Yeah? So I really think my point of view, we should try to teach them to compete. Maybe when they are 5, 6, 7, just education. Yeah? Just learn things. My point of view. Okay? In this workshop, I'll tell you how I think that futsal should be. Yeah? How I've used futsal to develop kids. And in my point of view, how it's much better to do it. You can take some things, take everything, or take nothing. Up to you. Yeah? Of course, I don't have the proper and real way to do it. Yeah? It's my way to do it. So, one of the things that we should try to do with kids is to have an aim for every day, an objective for every game. Yeah? And the objective for this game is not the need to win this game. Okay? We are educating them. So if you don't win, nothing happens, yeah? But our aim for the game, for the kids, should be every day to learn new technical show means. When we have this chat before the game, okay, today let's try to, I don't know, to press them, yeah? And this should be our aim. If we do this properly, we won the game for us, yeah? Then we can lose, we can win, this is not important with kids, yeah? But they need to focus on this, yeah? And you need to reward them if they do this properly. This is the most important thing. Seventh thing, aim for the game, 100% effort. Yeah? We need to teach them to give their best, yeah? Because then they will use this in other situations of their lives, not just in sport, yeah? So in every game, it's mandatory for them to have this. Yeah? Then fellowship, be part of a team, yeah? Part of the education when you play a sport is to be part of a team, yeah? And you are, most of you, when you are working, you are part of a team. And some of you, you've learned this when you've been playing a sport team, yeah? And then compete, yeah? My point of view, okay, maybe with really small kids, no? But then they need to compete. Yeah, maybe they won. Either one, they lose or they win. But at least they've been competing. Yeah, this will be challenging and will help us to that they learn some things. Yeah? The score then is relevant, yeah. Of course, if we are all the coaches, we want to win, yeah? And but it's not important if you win like the under-8 local competition of Emerson Road. Yeah? Who's gonna say, okay, you're the best coach because you've done this. Yeah, so for me it's more important when I've been lucky that I've been coaching a kid that now has arrived to play in first division. And this has never happened to me, but I'm feeling I'm part of it. Yeah? Maybe another coach would have done the same and he would have arrived anyway. Yeah? But the most important thing is when they learn and they are better person with us. Yeah? More things. Coaching teams with young players. My kids, let's try to do in all the exercises more games than circuits. Yeah? Circuits are fine and are really easy for coaches to do it. So let's do a dribbling here and then we shoot and then you go to the other side, let's do it. Yeah? And as a coach I'm like this. Yeah, and I don't have problems with kids because they don't argue each other. But it's not the best way to develop them. We can use them sometimes, but try to play more games. So they are all active, they are all participating in the exercise, yeah? Avoid cues, almost the same. I can do an exercise where I have a queue of 10 players and they shoot one time to the keeper and then they go to the queue. Or I can create an exercise where they are all the time shooting, yeah, and then it's to have balls and shoot to the other side and they are active all the time, so they are more time playing. Yeah? So very important, avoid cues all the time, please. Okay? If we can, one ball for play, yeah? These cards, it's money. Sometimes we need to carry with balls. Okay, I'm going with a moment and it's very hard for me to carry on with with 12 balls every day, but it's fine. And if they can always have a ball, then definitely become better. Yeah? Size of the ball. We have size 5, which is football, size 4, futsal. And then with younger kids we should use this, yeah? In Brazil, they are proud of that. They say that they are so technical because they use smaller balls with smaller kids, yeah? So we have Jack and Will here that maybe they use, like after using size 4, 14, yeah? 13, yeah? Okay. They are in the limit to use size 3, size 4, yeah? So if you have a bigger foot, you can use this ball. If you have a smaller foot, you can use a heavier ball and a bigger ball, yeah? You need to adapt it. So maybe this ball, size 2, yeah, it's a different. Yeah, it's very different, yeah? It's a nightmare for the clubs to have it, because I need to have like 4 bags of balls, yeah? If I have one and you have it for all the ages, it's much better for me. But with this, I really think that we can have better players with better technique. Okay? Size 2, that is this, maybe from 6 till 9, more or less, then size 3 till 12, 13, and then size 4 for the others. Yeah? Perfect. More tips. Shopkeepers. Yeah, depending on the age, of course. But when we are from 5 till 9, don't specialize them as a keeper, yeah? Everyone needs to be in net, try how a keeper feels. If not, oh, you are very bad in the goal. Okay, let's see how you do it. Okay? Then when they are older, of course, we need to specialize them. But when they are kids, some of you are from schools or you will work with under 8, under 7, under 4, yeah? Or everyone needs to be in net, yeah? Someone will like it more. But everyone needs to try it at least one time, yeah? More technique and less tactics, yeah? If you arrive to other division and you have
Ernest, yeah, Ernest,
and he's been learning from great coaches and tactically he's brilliant, yeah? But Ernest doesn't know how to play with, he doesn't know how to do a pass, yeah? Maybe he'll be a really good coach, but never a really good player, yeah? So we need to have technique with kids, technique. And you'll see that you can develop technique in so many different ways, yeah? Not just the typical way to dribble a goal or to repeat 20 times that Cristiano Ronaldo does, the step forward. Yeah, different ways to do it, but technique. And then we can introduce step by step the tactics, yeah? Another tip, really good, introduce a shoot. Mainly all the exercises, we can introduce a shoot at the end. And the kids love it, yeah? Because they love to score and win, yeah? So if we introduce a shoot in any kind of exercises, I mean, if you have a ball possession at the end, you can introduce a shoot when you whistle and they can shoot. they'll have fun and it's a point with kids, yeah? And then, at the end, maybe in the 90% of the drill, of the exercises, try to introduce some kind of opposition, yeah? We'll go through the kind of opposition, but it's fine, maybe the first time we are doing something, maybe we are learning to do how one step up, okay, with non-opposition. But then, we need to introduce something, yeah? So they are all the time making decisions, yeah? You'll see that futsal is about making decisions all the time, so all the exercises should be based on that, yeah? Making decisions, because that is a so quick sport that if they've been learning and developing themselves with this all their life, then they'll decide much better, yeah? You can see in first division, lots of players that they have so many skills, tactically they are so good, but their decision making is really, really bad, okay? And that's why they are not that good. Okay, so what do things then? We'll go through these things today, yes? Technique, okay, you'll see which kind of techniques. Basic tactical aspects, like two against two, counter-attacks, you'll see this. Some strategy, okay, some set pieces, easy things. Yeah, but they learn it when they are 5, 6, 7, 8 years old, and then when they become older, they'll it will be easier, yeah? We have here Thomas that plays with me, and he can say that it's a nightmare in our first team set pieces, yeah? And why? Because I have got so many English players that they've never done this, yeah? Because they've never played futsal before, yeah? But I have Martí and Pablo that they come from Spain, and when you were, I don't know, Pablo, he was playing at my school as well. Under 10, you were doing at least one set piece, yeah? So now for him, it's a bit easier because he used to it, yeah? Then, understand the game. So, for me, when I was playing, and I had a coach whose name is Kenny, now he's second coach of FC Barcelona, he showed me how to understand the game, yeah? And I became a really good, not really good player, but so much better when I understand the game, yeah? How it works, why I'm moving, why I'm doing things, yeah? Why I'm going forward, why I'm staying, why I'm doing a vlog and then I continue. So we need to teach them, why do the things? No, okay, let's do a parallel pass, okay, let's do a volley. Why do we do the things? Yeah, we need to teach them this, okay? And at the end, as I've said, take good decisions, all the time, all the time, all the time, and quickly, because it's a quick sport. Yeah, it's not like football that we can have all those time. 4 against 4, small core, okay, quick decisions. Yes? So, let's go through the ways of opposition. One example, non-opposition. Yeah, very easy. I'm doing an exercise. Ernest, you need to drive the ball. Yeah, drive the ball. Nobody's bothering me. Okay, from one side to the other. Non-opposition. But now we can do one step more. Yeah, mobile players. I'm doing the same. I'm driving the ball from here to there. But I have 6 mates that are doing the same, and maybe they are doing like in this way, yeah? So I'm crossing each other. So it's a kind of position, quite easy, but a bit harder, yeah? So I need to drive here, but I need to be aware because I cannot cross with him, yeah? So it's a bit harder. With kids, we start non-opposition. They're a bit better. Maybe we do one line here, one line there, so one thing to be worried about, yeah? One more thing. Another thing, another way of opposition, recovery, plus one we call it, yeah? That means, imagine that I need to finish, yeah? For me, the coach is telling me, you come from there, from half court, you need to drive and shoot. Is it easy or not? Easy, yeah? Okay? And I'm in a rush. No, yeah? Options we have. Okay, you need to do this in 3 seconds. Okay, 3 seconds, but maybe I'm really fast and he won't chase me. But, let's do it now with a defender behind me. Yeah, now it's harder for me because I need to go quick. If I don't go quick, he'll chase me, he'll tackle me, and I won't be able to score. Yeah, so plus one, good for finish, for driving as well. So every time he passes me the ball, I have one player behind me that goes around the corner and he's trying to chase me. Yeah, so we are putting speed in all the action, the technical action. Yeah, perfect. Let's defend us. That means, that we have imagine that we're doing a long possession, instead of doing it 4 against 4, we'll do 4 against 2, which is easier for the players. Yeah, or when we are working on 1v1, we have 5 players attacking, we have 2 defending. Yeah, so you might find one player, you need to be aware of other players, so it'll be harder for him, okay, to tackle me, because he needs to be aware of more things. So with kids, try to always, at least at the beginning, till they are a bit much better, use less defenders. Yeah, if you start doing a ball possession with 4 against 4, it won't work. They do 2 passes, the ball will go outside, and they won't touch the ball. If you do it, you want to develop the pass, you play 4 against 2, or maybe at the beginning 4 against 1. Okay, it will be hard, but it will be challenging for them. Yeah? It's not that easy for the kids to control and pass. A player is coming, I need to do it quick. Then a bit much better, 4 against 2. Then a bit much better, 4 against 3. Yeah, in games, in everything. Okay? Then defender with handicaps. I'll tell you this after. Okay, you'll see it. Okay, then real opposition and then time. Yeah? So when I'm saying that we can use always 90% of the time an opposition means this, yeah? We can use all these things. Except this, which is the other 10%. So don't hesitate to all do it all the time doing without opposition. Try to use this kind of things that are useful. So, okay, because the kids need to be aware about different things. Perfect. This is an example of programming. We won't go through it. Okay, this is for our academy. But you can see it's an under 12. It's more or less all the things I think we should develop with them. You can see it's more of a technique at the beginning, even more. Okay, and then we introduce some things about the attack. 2 and 2, maybe at the end 3 and 3, but we never go through 4 and 4. Okay? But maybe it's technique that is available.
Yeah, you can have the internet, have a look at home. Okay, it's an option.
It's not, it doesn't need to be like this. Yeah? So, futsal technique. What do we need to go through? Different things, yeah? Run with the ball. Dribbling, shoot, pass. Pass related with control.
Every time we are doing a pass, we have a control.
Yeah? And finally, the feint. Yeah? And most important thing, maybe, you use proper size of ball.
Yeah. And I can say that in Spain, we just have size 3, we don't have size 2. But with more kids, we should have size 2. Yeah, because it's not that useful for us.
Okay, so let's go through the first one. Yeah, run with the ball. Things we need to do with this, yeah? Drive with different surfaces.
Pablo, thank you.
Okay, so soul is very important in futsal, okay? And it doesn't need to be like this. But some, we need to teach them at least to drive with the soul many times, yeah? But they can also drive with
external power, okay, different things, yeah?
One easy exercise would be that Pablo drives the ball with the soul, okay? Let's see how Pablo does it. Okay, you go there and come back with the soul. Okay? Okay, with the soul, yeah? The ball is on the side of him, okay? He comes back. Okay, so we need to teach them this, yes? And this not, doesn't mean to be that in futsal you need always to drive it like this. No. We had that some players that in some situations they drive it like this. And it's fine. But if you want to have it closer, that's why we always use the solid futsal, yeah? To have the ball close to that. Okay, we'll see it on some exercises. And for Pablo, sometimes when you start with kids, they drive like this. Yeah? So, and this is solid, but it's not useful because you're going to run. Okay, so let's see it again, how he has the ball on his side, let's run it. Okay? Okay, and again, with the ball on the side. Yeah? Perfect. Then, change direction. Very important to teach them this. So in the exercise, okay, I want to develop to run with the ball.
Yeah, we can do a line, but in a real game, this will happen just maybe in a counter-attack.
So we need to create exercises, so they need to decide and change directions.
Okay, so maybe Pablo will go this way, you go swap, cambiar la dirección. Okay, so we need to teach them that they turn the ball with the foot, okay, different kind of techniques, okay, that they need to change direction.
Yeah, of course, like in football, with futsal, most of the time, with the sole. Yeah, kick it out.
Like in football, if you are playing like this, just Messi is good. playing like this.
Yeah, the other one, so we need to raise our head and see what's happening. Yeah?
He's like this, and he can do a pass. I cannot do it.
Yeah? Okay. Then both legs, of course, and each contact will say this, like, if maybe I'm thinking over you in football because it's much easier for you, but players like Pedro plays with both legs, plays in Chelsea, very useful for everyone. Yeah? But in futsal, we have Lim, who plays in Barcelona futsal, who plays with both legs, very useful. Yeah? We go through it as well. Okay, and last thing, pivot movement. Yeah? Tom? Okay, Tom will defend Pablo. Okay, in futsal, you'll see it after this, we have the pivot, okay? Pivot plays usually on top, so you play the striker, you defend Pablo. Okay, behind you. Okay, so pivot usually plays backwards to the net, so imagine that the net is over there, okay, and Pablo plays with me, and Thomas is defending this net over there, yeah? So he usually plays like, usually Suarez, but it's backwards to the net, okay? And we need to teach them to get this ball and protect it, yeah? Because Tom will try to defend it, so I don't want to put it on his leg, okay? And we usually will teach them to go with him and keep passing back to us, yeah? Okay, so to protect the ball, you've seen some of the stresses we do today, okay, and then to give it back to the players. Yeah, so a very important thing, yeah. One thing that we can teach them is to drive with the ball backwards, okay, do it from there, okay. Okay, with defender, with no defender, on the line like we've been doing before, okay. An important aspect is to do it with the ball. Yeah, so first exercise, yeah, don't worry about this. You can make us done a really hard effort to translate it into English. Some things you won't understand it. I hopefully yes. Yeah? But if you don't remember what it says, you'll get it. So, first of all, we call it Pac-Man. Yeah? So you are making the turn around over there and you'll see it. Yeah? Then we go to another one and to another one. But forget about this, just focus on the exercises. Yeah?
You have it here, you have the presentation. So we think it's going to it. Yeah, you'll see it there, it's the same. Okay? Let's go there.
Thank you.
Thank you.
training because we are now compared to the yeah? Okay, fine. So, another way to run with the ball and the camera, yeah? And the last one, yeah, maybe a little bit difficult. So, what do we want to do?
So it's good that they need to pass the ball, but they also need to dribble properly.
Yeah? And in futsal, because you play 4 against 4, in lots of situations you can get out with one and it's really good for anything. Yeah? Okay, so, we're training. Methodology, yeah? Please, first explain. Yeah, so we are doing one step over. Okay, I dribble, like this. Okay, I pass the leg on the ball and then I carry on. Yeah? Then I show it. With the ball I do it. So they get it. Yeah, and finally I go right. Okay, you come on this. Or when you go out, you go this way. Or you need to move your body in order to try to fool them, yeah? And then go to the other side, yeah? Yeah? Fine. Then, to start working on this, the same, let the defenders and let him play it. Yeah? Think and see this if you want to get started. Yeah? Then, you defend the handicaps, we'll speak about in a sec. Okay? And then, use competitions, they like it. You can do some competitions, one with one, and then they swap. Okay? So, okay, I want you 3-2, 1-2. So they have this attitude to try to dribble all the time. Yeah? In a real situation. Yeah? And then when we have really good players, because we first need to teach them how to attack, we can give defensive tips to make it a bit harder for them. Yes? Fine. So, first exercise. We have 3 exercises. Yeah. Fine. Okay, first exercise. What is one with defending handicap? Yeah?
What does it mean? Let's turn around again.
Sorry about it. So, I can do the exercise before.
Okay, so pass. Okay, go. Go back. Right, and we're meeting that door in the prison bell. Yes? So when you walk in, you say, door in the prison bell. Okay? You say it here. You are that. So when you walk, you say, door in the prison bell. On the door, you say, same motion, yeah?
Thank you.
players that are moving to the league we are wearing. Or maybe in a few years, yeah, or something like this. Yeah, but they, it's another thing to think about. Yes, or maybe not. Yes? Okay, so the same, you can do it.
Okay.
Yes, we do it games, but this tool, this game is very, very important. Yeah, we do this work. Yeah, I think that should be done. Okay? So, now the ball of the ball, the ball, the ball, the ball, the ball, the Shoes and finish, yeah?
Happens all in futsal, of course. Yeah, more space, less space,
so we should allow.
Maybe. I've been watching today Barcelona playing.
And Spala. I think it was like 19 shoes of Barcelona.
Okay, and 12 on target.
Yeah,
a bit different than in
football. Yeah, maybe one thing to shoot 2, 3, 4, 5 times. Okay. So very important to develop this, yeah?
Shoot, different faces, yeah? Maybe the biggest difference, Pablo, can you pass me a ball?
Yeah.
So you can shoot external, which is not very common in futsal, but it's, why not, you can do it.
Okay.
You can shoot with laces, internal, okay? Maybe the biggest difference that some football players are also using is the toe.
Yeah? Why? Because it's quicker. Yeah? You don't have the same accuracy, but it's quicker, yeah? More space, more players, more intensity, so.
Okay, for me, I'm long, when I shoot, I need to do like Tirani. I need to think about bring the leg here and shoot, so it takes me
1 or 2 seconds to shoot all the time.
If you shoot with the toe, it's very strong shoot, and it's very quick, yeah? So they use it a lot to develop it.
But don't focus just on this.
Try to develop the other one as well, yeah? Fine. With kids also, teach them how to shoot up, yeah? Because they shoot, and some of them, they don't want to shoot on top, and they don't know how to do it, yeah? And to teach them to put the ball, either put under the ball, okay? And bring the leg weight up, yeah? Okay, good.
So they will do it.
Yeah? Another thing with shoot, what I've said before, yeah? Persecution, yeah, as one.
So instead of doing one against the keeper, I do it, but someone is chasing me, who gets carded for me. Yeah, maybe we start with no one chasing me when they have something, some skills to do it.
Then they introduce the persecution. Yeah? We need to teach them to shoot after dribbling as well, so not just against the keeper, so you dribble and then you shoot, okay? Okay, and a good tip as well is to combo, yeah? To put some competitions with kids. Makes it more real and it's fine. Yes? Okay, 3 more exercises about it.
This one I really like it. Let's go through it.
Okay guys, one more game.
Yeah.
stay there, okay? You should. Okay? Then you should. Great. Okay? What do you do in your name? You should. Okay? Very good as well, you can say, because you have the reward. Yeah? And they come you. Coach, that's good. Thank you. Yeah? And advice, in case, if you can be one man, it's fine, yeah? Because we have always one player that will never score the goal. Yeah? So we can make him at least score one goal. If he has one goal, okay, it's not going to feel crap. Yeah, so if you are in one net, you say, oh! Then, but you don't say that because you can go on thinking when you have it. Yeah? Okay, fine. So, certainly, yeah, but before this, because we have then a long way to go, not here because there's more work, we can use this space to develop something, okay? So, after you show, sorry, I haven't said, if you don't show, unfortunately, you don't get any more. You go to the other side and you don't get any more. Yeah, so we have a shoot. So, save it all. Okay? I know you have time to become my goal. Yeah? If I score, I get the goal, I go to the other side. Yeah? But now, when I'm ready to the other side, we drive like this. Yeah? Okay? And then, set up and shoot when I get the goal. Yeah? I go to the goal to drive with the soul. Okay? Or drive like this. Up to you, but you have to make this time, this space to put some technical thing. Yeah, that's right. Okay, so we have to put it down here. Okay, when you say your name, you should have to go to the left. Don't do your fingers, don't break my laptop. Okay, come on.
Thank you.
Okay, we have another finish.
Me, bon, ti, casa 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 me, bon, ti